Hey guys, welcome to another exciting tutorial of creation process, and in this video we'll be creating a 3D logo. Last week I couldn't upload any of the video tutorial because I was working on my new website which I'm going to be launching very soon. So sorry for that, and so let's begin with the tutorial. So we will make a text using the ellipse tool. So in the here, select the ellipse tool and make a circle. Now duplicate it by clicking Ctrl C and Ctrl F to paste it in the front and scale it down. Once you've done that, select both of them, scale it a little bit bigger, select both of them, go to Pathfinder and subtract it. Now make a rectangle from the center here and this much big. Now with the rotate tool, place an anchor point here and click and drag with the shift click on your keyboard. It will rotate to 45 degree angle. Now select both of them and subtract it. So after you've done that, select the shape, go to effect, 3D, extrude and bevel. The extrude and bevel is a cool option to create a 3D surface using the 2D graphics. So first of all, we'll set all the angles to 0. So 0, 0, 0, and 0. Now you can preview it by clicking here, small box, and click text. Now, turn a little bit of angle, this one. And we will increase the depth by using this. You can increase the depth here, and you can even adjust the perspective view. You can increase the perspective here. But before that, we have missed one thing, so I'll cancel that. And we'll make a rectangle here from here, a small bit of height, this much. Select both of them and combine it. So you get a small extension here. Now do the same process. Go to Effect, 3D, Extrude and Bevel. Set all the angles to 0. Except this. Just tilt a little bit of angle. Now preview, you can preview it here. Extrude the depth and increase the perspective. Perspective brings a cool depth here with the perspective view, and you can adjust the depth from here, and with a little bit of placement in the angle, just play with few angles. Okay, so once you've done that, click OK. Now go to Object and Expand Appearance. And with that, go to Object, Expand, go to Object, Expand, go to Object, Expand. Expand it for 2 to 3 times because the object is comprised of 3 to 4 shapes, so it all needed to be expanded. So expand and add the end, ungroup it. So every part will be separate, ungroup it for Ctrl Z, ungroup it. So every surface will be separate here. This one is separate, this one is separate, this one is separate. So you can easily give a different texture to each surface. So after you have done that, just select each of the surface. This one, this is made up of, this is one surface, this is another. So this, select this and in the Pathfinder combine it. Select this, combine it. Select this portion to combine it, so this will become the whole surface, one surface. So after that, we'll apply some texture color corrections here. We'll apply some gradient. So select the surface, apply some gradient, and select the radial one, put this here and this one here, and let's adjust, change this color to a little bit of oranginess, and with the gradient tool, play with it. Once you get that, once you get what you want, do the same step here. Apply the gradient here, change it into radial, and increase its darkness here this much. Now with the gradient tool, play with the gradient. Let's give it here darkness and here lightness, like this. So just play with it and give a nice depth in here. Select this one with the eye drops. You can select the gradient here and apply the gradient. So this one, after that we'll go to the upper portion, this small pawn, and apply the gradient here. We will apply some lightness, light portion, and just play with the gradient. Make it linear and apply it. Or maybe you can remove this and just darken this portion a little bit more and apply the gradient here. After that, do the same thing from here. Apply the gradient using the gradient tool. Play with the shades. So like this, apply the gradient, apply the shades. So after that you got a nice 3D depth. So once you've done this, we will select this object and place it in the center. Now we'll make a shadow effect. So now with the rectangle tool, we'll draw a small rectangle here in the down, make it black, and effect blur, Gaussian blur, and play with the Gaussian blur. Preview it, you can hear, and adjust the blurriness you want. When you achieve that, click OK. Now go to transform, skew, shear. You can use shear and just tilt to an angle in which you want. You can preview it here, this one, okay, this much, and click copy to duplicate the one and place it here. In the same way, select the other one and just keep this applied and go to the same stuff here, shear, and rotate it to some opposite angle, maybe this side, and click OK. Once you've done that, place it, arrange it to the back, and do the same stuff here, arrange it to the back. So this will be your shadow. We will reduce the opacity here, just select both of them, go to transparency and reduce the opacity to around 30%, maybe, or you can increase it, but we'll keep this much. Now duplicate it, Control C, Control F to paste it in the front, and scale this small under one to a smaller size and keep it here. Increase the opacity to 40%, scale this one too and keep it here, and increase opacity to 40%. So we'll have created a depth shadow. Now we will create here, a little bit of shadow is missing, so we'll create a small one strip here connecting both of them. Go to effect, blur, Gaussian blur, preview it, increase their blurness, okay, do transparency and reduce to 30%, and you got a cool, a nice shadow effect here. So this is how you can create 3D text or 3D logo in Illustrator. Hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Thank you very much.